One of the priorities certainly to have the Lisbon Treaty implemented. The institutional changes in that treaty are of great importance to make the Union more efficient in its everyday work. Well, it's very hard to explain developments in the international sphere. People are looking to what is happening close to them in their town, in their village or region. And of course, if you can make obvious, visible, that Europe has an impact there, I suppose that will help them to see that indeed the impact is almost everywhere.
Η Ελλάδα είναι από τις πιο φιλοευρωπαϊκές χώρες στην Ευρωπαϊκή Ένωση. Νομίζω ότι οι προτεραιότητες μας είναι κυρίως η συνοχή της Ευρωπαϊκής Ενώσεως, η συνοχή των διαρθρωτικών και των άλλων ταμείων και η ανάπτυξη όσο περισσότερο γίνεται κοινών πολιτικών σε διάφορους τομείς. Ως προερχόμενος από το Υπουργείο Εξωτερικών, με ενδιαφέρει και πάρα πολύ η ανάπτυξη της κοινής εξωτερικής πολιτικής και νομίζω είναι από τις προτεραιότητες της Ελλάδας. Αυτό είναι ένα πρόβλημα το οποίο δεν ισχύει μόνο στην Ελλάδα. Ισχύει σε πάρα πολλές χώρες και νομίζω σε άλλες χώρες είναι πολύ πιο έντονο από ό,τι είναι στην Ελλάδα. Και η κυβέρνηση και η αντιπολίτευση κάνουν ό,τι μπορούν ώστε να δώσουν μεγαλύτερη δημοσιότητα στο έργο της Ευρωπαϊκής Ενώσεως και να ευαισθητοποιήσουν όσο περισσότερο γίνεται τους πολίτες ώστε να συμμετάσχουν στις εκλογές. Είναι ένα πείραμα, ένα έργο δύσκολο, αλλά πιστεύω ότι η Ελλάδα, η οποία στατιστικά έχει καταγραφεί ως μία από τις πιο φιλοευρωπαϊκές χώρες, θα το καταφέρει.
Well, joining Europe has many facets. It is definitely not a matter of seeing what you can get out of Europe, but more of, shall we say, what Europe and your own country can do. And on this score, I think we have, although we are a very small country, I think our population is either just above or just below that of Leeds. I think we have done our bit to contribute towards the progress of Europe as well. Definitely Europe has helped us. And we have now a voice in Europe, which is extremely important. And at the same time, we believe that the stronger Europe is, and having one voice in the international field is very important even for us, especially as we are small, and by joining forces with Europe, what we believe is right can be said and can be drummed in with greater emphasis. People of Malta at the moment are rather worried about illegal immigration, and we have drummed and drummed and banged the drum to try and get Europe to understand our precarious position, and thank God, Europe has. Well, Malta goes against the trend there. We vote in large numbers, and in fact in national elections over 90% of the population votes, so that's a very strong turnout. In the EU referendum for membership, and also in the first election for European MPs, MEPs, the turnout was strong, and I don't think we really need to do very much to get people to go out and vote.
Like everybody in the Western world, we are quite uncertain at the moment about the future, so that dictates also the attitude towards Europe and European cooperation. But everybody says that we should need a European policy on immigration, we should have a European policy on the fight against criminality and what have you. So you can't have it both. I mean, you can have it both, but then please come together and work together in the European framework. Young people from Hull and Rotterdam are going to work on a project to interest local communities more in European politics in order to increase the turnout during the European elections both in Hull and in Rotterdam, which is quite a challenge, but an interesting challenge, and it shows that there is still idealism left in Europe, that that young people see the necessity and the profit of European corporations.